Gavin's Good News Vlog. This is the place to come for all the best of positive, upbeat and happy stories around on the internet and around in the world in general. Thanks very much indeed for being with us today. Let's kick off first with an inspirational story. 8-year-old Daisy May Demetra. Daisy May Demetra is a young model who has been signed by River Island. River Island are a big high street fashion brand in the UK. They're known sort of for their affordable, cool, well-made designs. And this 8-year-old, Daisy May, has been signed to an agency, a modelling agency for a while, only a young girl, but the key thing about her is that she has got prosthetic legs. She's got blades essentially as her legs, and she's being put up now as this poster girl for disabled models. She's trailblazing away to becoming a sort of mainstream household name in the sense that she's sort of breaking taboo and breaking the boundaries, and she's turning heads essentially by getting involved in this active wear campaign for children. And it's an absolutely amazing story because I just think that people like her, people like Daisy May, you see people like her front and center of a big mainstream campaign, it's just, it kind of inspires. So she's going to be modeling in their activewear range, and the company River Island have said that they designed the brief to fit to the right person in each category. So being an active and sporty person was exactly the type of person, exactly the type of model they wanted to cast in this. I just think that's phenomenal because it shows that it doesn't matter whether you have a disability, it doesn't matter you know, what is stopping you from achieving your goals. If you are the right person that they want to front that campaign, then you're gonna be able to do it. She's already known for doing a lot of training in the gym. Her dad helps her out by doing some gym work. She's also modeled at London Fashion Week on the catwalk. I think it's really good that brands are now thinking outside the box and casting and being a bit more diverse in how they apply their models and their figures to launching a range. So Target, Hilfiger, ASOS have got ranges out there for disabled people, if you like. I think this is an absolutely phenomenal achievement of Daisy May here, and long may her success continue. Next up, Hollywood's highest grossing actor, The Rock, aka Dwayne Johnson, has surprised a stuntman that has worked with him for around 17 years actually, in a viral video, which is a really emotional viral video actually. So The Rock he staged an interview with Tanoy Reed, and Tanoy Reed is a really well-known stuntman in Hollywood and has done loads of films. He's deputized for The Rock, I think, for quite a few films as well. You know, you'd think The Rock would do his own stunts actually, but I think Tanoy Reed is a very well-known chap, and he staged this interview to pay tribute to him, and he sort of says, you know, gives him a lot of, you know, glowing remarks. Out of nowhere, when he sort of finished giving him his, you know, his spiel, he just gives him a pickup truck. He's so overwhelmed by it that Tanoy Reed is so overwhelmed by it. I think The Rock's got quite a few pickup trucks. Certainly got more than a few pickup trucks. But yeah, Tanoy Reed has just broke down in tears. He was really overcome with emotion. It just shows the power of, you know, someone like The Rock, someone who is, someone who's got so much going for him, someone who's got so much positivity around him. And also, I think what it does, is, I think what this video has done is that it's highlighted how tough being a stuntman in Hollywood is. When he wrote this post about the video, he said that you know, Reed has broken loads of bones, torn ligaments, you know, bust tendons, all these injuries which are just horrific for the regular person to bear. Hollywood really appreciates you. The acting industry really appreciates you, and stuntmen generally don't get the light of day that they should get, really. So The Rock has done a fabulous thing here by showcasing the hidden side of Hollywood, you know, the unsung heroes, really, in Hollywood. Have a gander and let me know what you think.
And I want to say from the bottom of my heart, I love you, I thank you, and enjoy your new truck.
No, man, what?
You're welcome, brother. Come on.
Damn.
17 years of him giving his blood, his sweat. I mean, this small token of my appreciation.
We love you, brother.
I love you too. Why you lying, bro?
Lastly, this is a footballer you may not have heard of before. His name's Ryan Edwards. He plays for Plymouth Argyle in the English Football League, so in League One, which is the third tier Plymouth got beaten in their opening game of the season against Walsall, but Ryan Edwards scored their goal, and it's his first goal since being diagnosed with cancer. So he was diagnosed with testicular cancer in January and scored against Walsall, scored his first goal since coming back to play. And, you know, it meant so much to him. He celebrated wildly, as you can imagine. But, you know, players coming back from, you know, a setback like cancer or what have you is such a phenomenal achievement, because you know, that long out of the game, you lose your, you know, your drive, your fitness, your desire really to play. But then to come back and then still play at the level, or sometimes better than the level you were playing at, is just an absolutely phenomenal achievement. So yeah, the club have tweeted their appreciation. Loads of other players, loads of other outlets as well have said what a wonderful thing it was. So congrats, Brian Edwards, scoring your first goal. It's a shame you lost, really, but next time. And that's it for this edition of Gavin's Good News Vlog. Thanks again for watching. As ever, please like, follow, subscribe, comment, and hit the notifications bell as well if you can, if you're watching on YouTube. Until next time, we will see you again with another show very, very soon. Have a good day, stay positive, keep happy, and yeah.